In this video, we will go over the process of configuring the Tableau Bridge pool, as well as how to add data sources to the allow list. Please note this video assumes that you have already installed Tableau Bridge on a dedicated virtual machine behind your firewall and have it connected with your Tableau Cloud site. If you have not done so already, please see the separate video for those walkthroughs. First, we'll dive into a brief overview of the differences between the default pool and a custom pool. The default pool can be utilized without the need for allow listing any domains and will work as a pool of clients, which the live queries and refreshes will be assigned out to based on the availability of the clients. A custom pool requires you to make a named pool and assign a specific bridge client or clients to it. It also requires adding a domain to the allow list to specify a bridge pool that the refresh will want to be pointed to. It also allows for more reliability, flexibility, and scalability, as you can add multiple bridge clients and pools depending on how flexible you want your environment to be. You can also direct data sources to specific pools using the allow list and add multiple clients for redundancies in case one were to fail. In general, we recommend that you use the custom pool because it allows admins to control which data sources refresh on Tableau Bridge. Next, we'll go over the process for allow listing flat files, domains, and WDCs for the custom pooling or named pools in Tableau Bridge. First, you're going to want to use the beginning portion of UNC file path when you're allow listing flat files. In this example here, the Z accounting is the first portion of the UNC file path that the Excel file is stored on. So in this scenario, you would enter Z accounting on the domain registry of the allow list in Tableau Cloud. Next, for domains and web data connectors, you're going to want to navigate to the data source page in Tableau Cloud and then go to the Connections tab and check under the Connects to section as highlighted in the screenshot here on this slide. These will be the domains that you want to add to the private network allow list in order to point to the correct bridge client to refresh on in the named pool. Instead, if you would like to do a range of domains, you can use a wildcard to include all subdomains as well, as seen by the example in this slide. Please note that WDCs cannot be refreshed on the default pool and are required to be refreshed through a custom named pool. Next, we will go over creating a custom named pool and adding data sources to the allow list. First, you're going to want to go to your settings page on the Tableau Cloud site and then select the Bridge tab at the top. First, you will notice that the bridge client is currently under the default pool because you have not set up a custom pool yet. In order to set up a named pool, we're going to go ahead and first select Add New Pool here, and then we're going to enter the name Pool 1, and then hit Save. Now, in order to move my bridge client into the named pool that we just created, we're going to go ahead and hit this pen icon down here, and then select the default pool and change that to Pool 1, and then select Save. And you'll notice now, if you click the drop down here, that my client is in the custom named pool in the Tableau Cloud site. Next, we will go over how to add a new domain to the allow list in order to point the refreshes in that domain to this specific bridge client under this named pool. First, we're going to go ahead and get our UNC file path here. In this example, it's just Z accounting as the machine name, and then it points to the Excel file here. We're going to go ahead and select Add New Domain. And then under the Domain tab, we're going to go ahead and copy the beginning portion of the UNC file path, and then we're going to paste it in the Domain section here. After that, you're going to go ahead and make sure this says Allow Permissions here for the domain permissions, and then select the pool here that we want to assign it to. And in this case, we only have one pool, so we'll select Pool 1 and then hit Save. This ensures that any files that are stored on this domain path are going to immediately be pointed to this bridge client under Pool 1 here. Next, we will go over the process for adding a domain or a WDC to the allow list for Tableau Bridge. Go ahead and navigate over to the Explore option here on the left, and then we're going to filter by all data sources, and then select the data source we want to add to the allow list, and then select the Connections tab, and then down here you will want to copy the domain here. Alternatively, you can go over and select this list view and copy the domain here as well. So we're going to go ahead and copy that, go back to the settings page, back to the bridge tab, and then click add new domain. We will paste in the domain here, ensure it's set to allow, and then select pool 1 and select save. You will want to repeat that process for each data source that you refresh on Tableau Bridge. Alternatively, you can add a wildcard to the beginning of the domain to include any subdomains as well. So it will be wildcard.mycompany.lan And then you can assign it to pool 1 and select save, and that will include any subdomains as well. Please know that as you scale your bridge environment, you can continue to add multiple pools and multiple clients to each pool to determine where you want your refreshes to go. Lastly, to confirm that your data sources are refreshing successfully, you can click here on the jobs page to verify that jobs are being successfully sent to Bridge. If you're seeing a no pooled agents assigned error, it's likely that the domain is not successfully added to the allow list yet and still needs to be added to the allow list. For more detailed information on configuring a Bridge custom named pool, as well as the common errors that you may run into during this setup process, please be sure to refer to the documentation below the video. Thanks for watching.